have also made the point that this book here by Patrick Bishop and Eamon Mali, which is sympathetic to you in some regards, they say that you're a member of the IRA during all that time. This book on Banded Country by Toby Harnder, says you're a member of the IRA. Okay, just a minute now. The biography of you by Liam Clark and Catherine Johnson, they go into some considerable detail about your role in the IRA.
Just a minute,
I'm not finished. Another book, Brian Feeney, who's done this history of Sinn Féin, he says you were in the IRA during all this period. Sean O'Callaghan, who you'll also be derisive of, but he was head of the Southern Command, he says you were in the IRA during all this period. Yes. Similarly, Brendan O'Brien, who again was very complimentary of your role in the IRA and otherwise, he says you were in the IRA during all this period. And Ed Maloney, who you have been scathing of, but he says you were in the IRA during all this period. Ed had extensive contacts within the Republican movement throughout most of the period of the conflict, and he knew in detail what was going on. All of these people say you were in the IRA during all that period. And before you answer, can I just make one further point? I was a reporter in Northern Ireland in the early 70s, and through that time I got contact with several people in the IRA, and I've talked to them over the years. And over the years, I've talked to several people in the IRA who've made mention of you in the context of you being a senior member of the IRA during all the period. Now, how come that we are all wrong? That all the intelligence agencies are wrong, all the Minister of Justice are wrong, and all these books that are written about the conflict in Northern Ireland, on my own experience, we're all wrong. How's that?
Because some people jump to conclusions.